Every series has like people that are always running, theories and just ideas of what's to come based off of information that we already have. You're always going to run into those people in fandoms because that's just part of having a fandom. I think that Chainsaw Man is the only one that, when it comes to like a theory, it doesn't, it's not like, oh yeah, I think this is going to happen like in this couple chapters based off this. It's like, oh yeah, that's logical. It's like, no, every single theory for Chainsaw Man always seems like a conspiracy theory. It feels like some tinfoil hat weird thing that it's like, man, that could never happen. But really, the that could never happen like theory is usually what is more likely in Chainsaw Man because it's such an odd series. Everything about Chainsaw Man is just very weird. Anyway, the chapter starts out. You got Aki talking to the Angel Devil, and he's like saying how. He's just like, oh, the issue right here, because they're discussing like, oh, in a couple, however long, I think it was a couple months. I don't know. It's like, you and the Blood Fiend will be killed by, by Chainsaw. Obviously, that being Denji, and the future can't be changed. Obviously, some weird stuff up and coming. I'm guessing it'll have something to do with like sending them to hell and some information, obviously, on the Chainsaw. It's probably will get revealed of like what makes the Chainsaw special, but. He's discussing like, oh no, I didn't come here to talk about that. Like, it's about you, because when it comes to like a devil hunter that is unable to kind of do their job anymore, like hurt on the job, obviously people lost their limbs. It's like, well, you on the other hand, like instead of retirement, they might just put you down. So like the best you can do is maybe try and form some contracts. There's some nice things in there. Like Aki is trying really hard to get him to a better like life now that he only has one arm. I'm wondering how long these guys are gonna have like one to no arms. Like, is this gonna be for the rest of the series, or is he gonna get an arm back? Like, I'm very curious of like where this is gonna go. Like, what exactly is going to be like the what exactly is gonna be the resolution on this whole thing on this weird disarmament, depression, sad guy face? Because it'll be really weird if, like, for the rest of the series, we just have the Angel Devil, but he's just has no arms. He's just kind of there. I'm hoping he forms a contract with Aki because he's a devil. He's not a fiend. He can form a contract with a human. Well, I don't know if humans can form contracts with fiends, but I mean, we know that devils can't form con or fiends can't form contracts with devils. So, how that is will be very interesting to see go out. Also, just as a small note, I like that his halo, it doesn't stay like on top of his head. It always just kind of like stays floating above him in like a. It's almost like it has a center point because it'll be like above him when he's just standing, but when he's laying down, it's above his face instead. I like that it just kind of seems to have like a center point of gravity that always kind of just will always want to be at, regardless of like if he's laying down, it won't follow him directly. But after that point, like he's talking to Aki, he's like, listen, I want you to know the people that I absorb with my powers, because you can absorb years off of people's lives and use that to like make like special weapons and whatnot. He's like, those people sometimes like come to me in my dreams, they haunt me, and I don't want you to die on this mission because I think you'll end up also, being in my dreams as well. He doesn't want more. He doesn't want more kind of like heavy thoughts on his conscience. He doesn't want more people to blame. And it seems like the Angel Devil originally was like a much more friendly and nice devil. Like he wasn't that much of an issue. And at that point, he's like talking about like they're talking about like getting with Makima. He's like, well, we should bring this to Makima together. We can see, what exactly is the scenario and what exactly the situation. And while they're talking, they're like, listen. I do know one way you won't be killed by the chainsaw is just leave and go far away, and he wants him to get away from this mission, but Aki doesn't want that. He wants Denji and Power to live. He's talking about like he can't like his brother and his family. Obviously, he doesn't have them anymore, and obviously with Himeno as well, he's got these people that are dead now and are constantly like putting strain on just his psyche. And now he's got two people to finally kind of talk to each other, and that is really interesting because he's finally got some people like in his life again, and so he wants to progress that forward. He wants to protect them. And so there was an interesting thing in here when he's talking to him, and he's like oh he's like, and Makima, and he's like, Angel Devil's like, you like Makima? And he's like, yeah, pretty much. He's like, well, why'd you fall for it? And he's like, why? He's like,
why was it? He doesn't really know. And so I'm going to talk about my theory in a moment, because while he's discussing like about what's going on, he's like, you know, I just want Power and Denji to be happy. I want them to survive. He says, you know, my brother's death was my fault. He puts a lot of this on himself, but he's like, listen, I'll make a contract. I'll make a contract with any devil. Like, he's ready to just whatever worst devil possible, whatever like is the most effective, he's going to go for it. And at that point, Makima's like, okay, will you form a contract with me? He's like, I'll give you strength. And like, we have this portion of a flashback with Angel Devil and the people that, you know, he was with, and it seems to have like some people that were pretty well to him. Oh, hang on a second. I was playing a game at the same time, but I went AFK. There we go. Anyway, small technical difficulty. Anyway, so at that point, he's like having this flashback of these people that, you know, he seemingly got in very peaceful with, he was very happy with, and then Makima showed up, and then there's like a blank period, and then the next thing he knows, he's like absorbed the life out of all these people, killed all these like people that were kind to him and brought him a happier life, and doesn't seem to really know why that is. He's just like, you know, it's like, oh, Makima brings death, and while she's talking, he's like, look at me, I want to show you your power, or I want you to show me your power, and like tells him it's an order. And at that point, like, it's daytime, and then the next thing he knows, it's nighttime, and all the people that you know that were with him are dead. So clearly, that's one of Makima's powers. And when Aki says he'll make a contract with him, so that's very interesting in the next chapter. So we got some interesting stuff going up, some more ominous stuff with Makima. Here's where I'm guessing Makima as a character is, and I legitimately think this is the case. So I thought for a while that maybe she's a hybrid, and I still think that's a possibility. She's either a devil or a hybrid, kind of like Denji and Reze and stuff. The hybrids are weird because we don't know how exactly the rules work. We know fiends can't make contracts with devils because even though they have a human body, they've been warped by a devil taking them over and becoming a fiend. So they can't form a contract with a fiend, or a fiend can't form a contract with a devil. We don't know if the hybrids can form contract with devils. We don't know if fiends can form. I don't think fiends can form contracts just based off of what's in the series. I don't know. Maybe I missed something. But maybe the hybrids could form contracts with devils and if maybe even fiends and maybe even with humans. And maybe that'll be the thing with the hybrids. That's their big thing, is they can still form contracts even while having devil powers. But it's either she's a hybrid or she's a devil. I feel like that's obvious. The question is, what is her powers based off of? And I know it sounds like it'll sound a little bit weird, but then you got to think about it. I think that either her devil power or her hybrid power. Let's just go with devil power, because regardless if she is just a straight devil or she's a hybrid like Denji, that I think her devil powers, it has to be broken OP, because we saw her go against the darkness devil. And that is a devil from a primordial human fear. It's not like, fear of guns, fear of spiders, fear of, of storms. It's a fear of the dark. It's the fear of the unknown, of like what lurks in the shadows and just in all these, literally just the fear of the unknown and like what horrors can kind of creep in there. So she also has to have something where it's more of like a base human concept of something that they can be afraid of. And I legitimately think that she either is or has a contract some way related to like a love devil, where it's something that has to do with like imagine it, her power is stemmed from the fear humans have towards like the ideal of love. And it's not just of like normal, like maybe you're like afraid of something, but also maybe of like knowing what people will do that offend people they love. They're like, they'll be completely irrational. They'd be willing to kill others and do things they wouldn't be willing to do outside of that. But keep in mind, like the way that she manipulates Denji is all based off of trying to make him have a strong emotional connection to her, because Denji had an actual, like, romantic link to Reze. They had a lot in common, they synced up and vibed really well. But with Makima and Denji, it's more about how she seems to be manipulating him. She's playing his heart, it literally is, his emotional setup is all attached to, you know, her being a marionette controlling him. You know, just puppet strings. And then this chapter, when you go back and see, like, he's like, oh, you know, you like Makima? And he's like, why'd you fall for it? And he's like, why? He doesn't really know why.
if she's got some form of, like, emotional, like, manipulation, like, part of her powers as well, but it would also make sense of why she's able to manipulate people so easily. Or maybe just an emotional devil. It's like the fear of emotions and kind of like thing. And it has to be something around that. I think it has to be something that's like some weird conceptual idea and not just like, oh, the fear of swords or the fear of avalanches or something. Fear of I don't know, war. I think war would actually be higher up there. I think that might kind of dip around into like, maybe not primordial, but it's definitely between like a primordial fear and just like a normal fear. But I think it has something to do, it'll have something to do with, like, a very base human fear. Something that is just deep-rooted in our psyche from just general human interactions. And I feel like taking something like that, something like, you know, the human emotions, or even just specifically, like, the idea of, like how humans love each other, and how, even though it could be positive for one side, it could be very dangerous for another. I think it would work, as well as it would be just further into the idea of Chainsaw Man. And especially when you think back at, like, when she went to go confront the Yakuza, the way that she got them to just completely be terrified of her and to get them to comply is by going after people they loved. And, like, again, I think it fits well with Makima, and I'm really hyped to see what exactly Fujimoto does with this. It was a very intriguing chapter, and it's more to talk about on this one on tinfoil hat theories of what's to come in the future. Like I said, like the stuff at the beginning, it was like, it's some interesting interactions between Aki and the Angel Devil stuff to come up in this next arc. And then some interesting stuff with the contract with Makima. But the big meat of like this is discussing what exactly is Makima, and if she's a devil or a hybrid, what is her devil or hybrid power? I think it has to be something kind of very crazy like that, where it's like, it is a base like human emotion or something that just stems from the building blocks of what makes a person. I don't know. Or even not even what makes a person, just like the building blocks of the human mind and like stuff that we're afraid of and stuff that like, you know, that can dictate like how we operate. Because she has a very strong emotional game and very strong like ability to manipulate others. And I think that would make a lot of sense for her power kind of stem from. Because she's also got seemingly another handful of powers, but who knows. Anyway, comment below, tell me your thoughts are about this, and tell me your thoughts are about this chapter and where you think Chainsaw Man is going. Like I said, it's a hard series to predict. I've gotten a couple things right, and I don't even remember what those were. All I can remember is like the few times where I'm like, I actually got something right with this crazy series. Anyway, other than that, comment below. Tell me your thoughts about this chapter. Tell me your thoughts about what's to come up in Chainsaw Man and what you're hyped for about most. I can't wait to see what happens to Aki. He can't die. I think he's going to become a hybrid. Anyway, other than that, though, comment below. Thumbs up the video for the like button, subscribe button, and check out my other videos. But other than that, I appreciate everybody who's already subscribed. And I thank you all for listening. Bye.